This tutorial shows you how to conduct the Friedman ANOVA, aka the Friedman Test in R, and interpret its results. Its purpose is testing the medians of the same or related individuals at three or more points in time for differences. For example, I want to see how good a 3-week exercise plan performs. That means, before implementation, I record the physical condition in some form of a test score, which is often considered as the baseline measurement. After the conclusion of the 3-week exercise plan, the same test is performed again, and a final time after 3 more weeks. I use the Friedman ANOVA to test for a difference in the median test score over time. The requirements for the Friedman test are the following: 3 or more measurements for the same individuals or matched sets of subjects, and a dependent variable on at least the ordinal scale. Before starting, please make sure your data is in the so-called long format for the analysis to work. As a first step, I want to see some descriptive statistics to get a first idea of my data. One can use the convenient dplyr package and pipes. Start with your data frame, add the pipes operator behind it, and use the group by function with your time variable, here simply called time. Follow this up with the pipes operator and use the summarize function for median and quartiles 1 and 3 on your test variable, here simply called value. My baseline measurement shows a median of 23. The first follow-up measure shows a median of 27.5 and 28 for the second follow-up measurement. Looking at the first and third quartile, the trends are somewhat comparable. You can also visualize the distributions for the three measurements using box plots. The interquartile range is represented by the height of the box, and the median by the black horizontal lines respectively. If you have circles above or below the whiskers, those are values that have the 1.5 times interquartile range distance to the edges of the box and are sometimes referred to as outliers. If those, however, are plausible values, you have no reason to worry. Now I want to finally test whether the medians are significantly different from each other or not. I use the Friedman underscore test function of the R statics package. I start up with the name of the data frame, df in my example. Next, the dependent or test variable has to go in. Here it is simply value. Follow this up with tilde, the small wave symbol, and then your time variable. Finally, the ID variable has to be added. You have to use a vertical line after your formula. You can usually find it between backspace and enter on your keyboard. My ID variable is simply called ID and matches the measurements to individuals in long format data. After running this line, I will get my test results for the Friedman test. The interpretation is straightforward. If the p-value is below the predefined threshold, for example 0.05, the null hypothesis can be rejected. Reminder, the null hypothesis for the Friedman test assumes no difference of the medians between the measurements over time. In my case, I defined alpha as 0.05 and can therefore reject the null hypothesis, because my p-value is very small with 5.46 times 10 to the negative 7. I can therefore conclude that the medians over time are different. After a significant Friedman test, post-hoc tests should be calculated to see between which of the measurements differences exist. An effect size for the Friedman test itself is optional. The two videos shown now will show you how to do both.